We were understanding about displacement current, and with the help of a capacitor, we saw three cases where there is an inconsistency, there was a problem with the Ampere's circuital law. What is Ampere's circuital law? Ampere's circuital law is B dot dl is equal to mu naught I t, where current is time dependent. Why this current is time dependent? Because we have a capacitor. If this current is flowing on this capacitor, so initially there was no charge, so some current was flowing, but as the current is flowing, this side is becoming positively charged and this side is becoming negatively charged. Now after some time, as the charges, positive charges have started accumulating on this side and negative charges have started accumulating on this side, the current will slow down because this positive charge will oppose further positive charge and this negative charge will further oppose the negative charge. So in that case, current will slowly decrease. That's why we have put this T here. Current is now time dependent even with the DC, and in case of AC, we know current itself is time dependent. And we have seen three cases of this capacitor. So we took a capacitor, so this is a parallel plate capacitor, and it is attached to a battery. So a time dependent current is flowing in this capacitor. Now we want to measure magnetic field at this point P. This P is outside the capacitor. So what we did, from Ampere's circuital law, so we create a circular path or called Amperean loop with R radius. So this is a circular Amperean loop which has center on this current. Center on of this Amperean loop is on this current. Now when we applied the Ampere's circuital law, B dot dl is equal to mu naught I and it. So what we found, so this is B dot dl, both of these are vector. So this circular path, integral of this circular path is 2 pi r. So B into 2 pi r was, this is into 2 pi r was simply mu naught of it. But when we chose the surfaces differently, so other surfaces was also enclosing this current but not touching the current. In the next case, what we did, we took the surface was like a pot. This surface was like a pot, and when we took this surface like a pot, this side was open. So ultimately this surface was not touching any current, but it is enclosing this current. So left hand side remains same, that means B into 2 pi r, but right side is now zero. When we considered a tiffin box kind of surface, again we find that left hand side is same and this is an open tiffin, this lid is not there. So B into 2 pi r is again zero because no current is touched by this surface. So we are solving for the same point, but still we are getting different results from different Amperean loops. But we should not get a different result, but here we are getting different results. And during his experiments, Maxwell found that there is some magnetic field inside this capacitor. That means some current must be associated, because inside also he was finding some kind of magnetic field. That means some kind of current must exist here as well. And that current is called ID, displacement current, because he was finding magnetic field inside too. So in the first case, this is perfectly valid. B into 2 pi r is simply equal to mu naught into I t. So this is for first part, first surface. When this is a circular surface or circular Amperean loop and this is touching the current. Now in another cases, we have considered these two Amperean loops which were enclosing the current but not touching this current. Since no current passes through the surface of figure 8.1b and c, so we can see in these two figures there is no current passes. So what we have a contradiction. Calculated one way, there is a magnetic field at point P. So in first case we found a magnetic field P, at P. B is equal to mu naught I upon 2 pi r. But here what we are getting, magnetic field equal to 0, in this way also 0. So there is some problem with the Ampere's circuital law. So the missing term, so what is the missing term? So Ampere's law must have been missing something. So Ampere's circuital law, this law must be missing something. So what was that missing thing? The missing term must be such that one gets the same magnetic field at P. So again, what we have to do, we have to add some term. So we get same magnetic field at P, that is equal to B is equal to mu naught I upon 2 pi r, and this I was time dependent. So we have to add such a term that we get the same magnetic field at P if we take any Amperean loop. So we have to modify this Ampere's law. So let us see how Maxwell modified this Ampere's law. So we can actually guess the missing term by looking carefully at the figure 8.1c. If we clearly see, then we can find what is the missing term. Is there anything passing through the surface S between the plates of the capacitor? So if we see this surface S, so is there something that is passing this surface? So that we have to see. So first of all, this was our capacitor and this side was positively charged. And this side was negatively charged. And we know electric fields. Let me make it a bigger version of this. This is positively charged. This surface is negatively charged. And we know even in vacuums, there is an electric field. And this electric field has a direction from positive to negative. So yes, of course, the electric field. So what we can see here, the electric field is still here, though there is no current passing. It seems that there is no current is passing, but electric field is still there. That is crossing this surface. If the plates of the capacitor has an area A, so now we are solving how to get that proper expression. So the plates now have area A and total charge Q. So total charge on the plates is Q and area is A. The magnitude of electric field E is Q upon A divided by epsilon naught. Because we have already learned this electric field on a parallel plate capacitor, let us talk about the magnitude, not the direction. So what is this electric field for a parallel plate capacitor? We have already learned this E is equal to simply sigma upon epsilon naught. So this is our electric field for parallel plate capacitor, and this sigma is nothing but charge density. So how can we write charge density? Charge upon area. So we can write this electric field as Q upon A epsilon naught. So this is our electric field, that is written here. So this electric field is Q upon A epsilon naught. The field is perpendicular to the surface S. So how we can see that this is our surface and this field is perpendicular to the surface. It has the same magnitude over the area of the capacitor plate and vanishes outside it. So the electric flux E through the surface S. So what we can see, this electric field is uniform across these plates inside this capacitor. This electric field is uniform, and as soon as we come out of this capacitor, this is everywhere, it is zero. Everywhere outside this electric field is zero, but inside the capacitor this electric field is Q upon A epsilon zero, and this is uniform. So now what is the electric flux through through this surface. So now we have to calculate what is the electric flux through this surface S. And let us see what is the surface S again. This surface, this blue colored surface is called surface S. So now we have to tell what is the flux. So electric flux, from Gauss law we know electric flux is electric field into area. This electric field into area is the flux. So what was electric field? We have already discussed E is equal to Q upon A epsilon naught. So this is Q upon A epsilon naught, this is electric field and multiplied by area. So area and area cancelled out. So this is our electric flux, Q upon epsilon naught, this is the electric flux passing this surface, passing through this surface.